Hey everyone, we're coming back on Data Exposed, and for the first episode here, we're going to talk about machine learning services in Azure HDInsight. Katherine's going to tell us more about what we've introduced in this new release and what are the various components that you can start leveraging right away with your HDInsight clusters. So join us for this video, and we'll have a lot of fun talking and demoing the capabilities. Yep. Welcome, everybody. We're here reviving the Data Exposed show, and the first topic that we have today on the Data Exposed show here is ML services in Azure HDInsight. We're doing a new announcement with Machine Learning Services 9.3. I'm Nishant Tucker. I'm a technical product manager for analytics and AI at Microsoft. And today, as a guest, we have Katherine Kampf. Katherine, why don't you introduce yourself?
Hello. Yes, as Nishant said, my name's Katherine. I'm a program manager on the Azure HDInsight team, and I'm excited to be here introducing our latest release of ML services.
Awesome. Thanks, Katherine, for joining us today.
Of course.
So we're talking about ML services in HDInsight. Let's do a quick refresher first on what HDInsight is for our audiences.
Yeah. So HDInsight, as some of you may know, is a fully managed analytics service hosted on Azure. So we let you spin up clusters in just a few minutes, and then it's got management capabilities on our end and a 99.9% availability SLA, and a bunch of tooling built around it, whether you want enhancements in monitoring or different development environments. We want to make it as easy as possible. We have a bunch of different cluster types, whether you want to use Spark, Hadoop, Hive, HBase, or what we're talking about today, which is our previously named R Server and now our new introduction of ML Services cluster type on HDI.
Perfect. Thanks, Katherine. So just to understand HDInsight better and move on to the ML Services part, HDInsight is our kind of open source offering for all the various cluster types. If you want to do streaming with Kafka and Storm, you want to do NoSQL with HBase, you want to bring in Hadoop or Spark, all of that as a hosted cluster environment within the Azure infrastructure over here. And you can leverage any of these open source toolkits and leverage them to your advantage.
Yep.
Now, all this while with HDInsight, we've had something called R Server.
Exactly. Yep.
And now, we are expanding this R Server capability to be machine learning services, which is really exciting. So now we are bringing Python in addition to R.
Exactly.
Tell me a little more about this, Katherine.
Yeah, so R Server, we saw it getting a lot of popularity in the R community. R users really loved it, but we know data scientists don't just use R anymore. Data scientists love Python as well, and we didn't want to alienate that audience, so we wanted to expand as many of our capabilities as possible to tailor to the Python community as well, and let you use both R, both Python, whatever you desire, if you want to use both, all within the same cluster type on HDInsight.
Now, this is really important. As Katherine mentioned, machine learning services brings the best of R and Python over here, trying to bring it closer to what your comfort zone is as a data scientist. And you can play around with any of the tools, any of the frameworks, any of the libraries in these languages, and bring them to distribute it across the Spark cluster in HDInsight. So tell me a little more about what the difference is with the ML services and the R server in HDInsight is.
Yeah, so of course Spark is a very exciting technology. We see a lot of usage for it in the open source community, and we as Microsoft wanted to be able to combine the power of that open source and the community around it with some of our proprietary investments in the ML and AI space. So with that, we've got a bunch of strong functions for parallelization and pleasingly parallel workloads, as well as some of our pre-trained models that we've built out that you can now use and take advantage of within the ML services cluster.
This is great. So in addition to just the Revolution R that is kind of imbibed so very natively inside of all of our assets, now we're taking Python and bringing that closer over here as well. With the help of like creating some of these algorithms and pre-training them so that you don't have to start from scratch.
Exactly.
Right. Yeah. Let's dig deeper into ML services and understand the individual components there, Katherine.
Yeah, so these are a few of our major features. Of course, we talked about the Python support, which is very exciting. And as I was mentioning, with this being a Microsoft investment, we have really easy, simple operationalization. So if you want to deploy in SQL Server, if that's where your data lives, we want to make that easy for you to do, or a RESTful API. We want to enhance all of those and communicate with a bunch of different Azure data sources or on-premises data sources to make sure that we can communicate with wherever your data lives. And we have a bunch of different parallel algorithms, or if you want to write your own, or you know, we know that data scientists want to use the best algorithm for their current situation. So if you want to try out H2O, if you want to use pure Spark with SparkLR or PySpark, we want to let you easily interoperate so you can try out a bunch of different things as a data scientist. We know it's a difficult process. You want to try as many things as possible, and we want to make it easy for you to do that.
Perfect. So you want to start with SQL Server. You have machine learning services on SQL Server. Mm-hmm. You want to move on to big data. You have machine learning services with HDInsight. Yeah. And then if you want to use some third-party libraries, you can go ahead and bring about SparkLR and H2O and all of that, the goodness of it inside of this environment over here.
Yeah, so we want to make it as flexible as possible for you to use your preferred libraries, languages, frameworks, et cetera.
Awesome. Enough of talking. Let's actually dive into some showing and telling about that. So let's see a demo on machine learning services and HDInsight.
So if we go, so I have an HDInsight ML services 9.3 cluster type, and this is my Jupyter hub, so I'm a big fan of Jupyter. And if you're an R user, of course, we ship R Studio as well, so R Studio Community Edition is available on the HDI Edge node. So easy for you to take advantage of that as an R user, but so I like Jupyter. So here's a simple example of training a model. So we can start off and get our Rx Spark Connect. So this will start off our Spark session. And we can immediately start taking advantage of some of the pure Spark capabilities. So we can use Spark read functionality and pull some data from a CSV. So this is a standard flight and weather data set. I'm sure you've seen it before. But we're going to be predicting airline delays, whether or not a flight will be delayed on 15 minutes. So you can see here we go through some standard Spark data transformations and split into our test and training data set. And so this is where we get into some of the ML services specific functionality with our RX logit function. And with this, we can train a logistic regression on those data frames we just built out. So right now we have a test data frame and a training data frame of built together of that flights data set and the weather data set to pull together some predictions on delays.
Now this is important to notice here, because ideally you would think that all of this is just part of Spark, but this is actually not part of Spark.
Yeah.
This is in addition to what the Spark functionality offers as part of its Python capabilities inside of Spark.
Yeah.
And we are extending that with the machine learning capabilities to take it even a step further by distributing algorithms that Spark natively doesn't understand. We pre-built them, we brought it to a stage where Spark can now distribute them natively inside, and we're using specialized functions like RxLogit to go ahead and distribute them.
Exactly, yeah. So we can train this model and pull out some of those key features we want to use. And then here we can see what our model looks like. And then we can pull in the help of another Rx function, RxPredict, to see how our model's performing. So we just trained on our training data set. Now we want to see what our testing looks like. So we use our predict function to put together our predictions based on our test data frame. And then we can even pull in scikit-learn to do some accuracy analysis, so we can look at the area under the curve and see where our model's performing. And it's about 64%, so it's a solid starting point. And from there, we could play around with different algorithms or different features to try to build that up. Or another good function that ML Services comes with is Rx ExecBy. And what this lets you do is say you only care about certain carriers in this flight scenario. Maybe you're looking for a new credit card, want to see who has the most delays, where you should invest in getting your miles. And so here you can actually use that same logistic regression function you just set up previously and split this up. You can use this keys equals carrier. And what this will do is divide up your data and build a model for each of those individual airlines, which is really powerful and can be applicable in a lot of situations. So here, obviously, we get a bit more variability in what accuracies we're seeing. So we've seen some a little lower at 62. But you can see we get some as high up as 68%, which is really great for individual carriers. Yeah, so that's an introduction of some of the new exciting functions we're bringing to Python. And of course, all of these are using the power of Spark, so they parallelize well and they run incredibly fast.
All right, so this also comes with all the goodness of the open source engine that Spark is itself. Yeah. So you don't have to learn a new engine altogether. You can bring all of your knowledge from the Spark perspective and extend it with newer algorithms, newer models, newer capabilities inside a Spark. Now, Katherine, tell us a little more about what the difference between these two is. Like, Spark has some Python and R capabilities with SparkR and native Python support inside a Spark with PySpark.
Yeah.
And what's the difference between what machine learning services offers and what Spark has natively?
Yeah, so it's a lot of what I said, the integration with the Microsoft ecosystem and our investments in AI and ML. So especially, I think one important thing to note is the pre-trained models. So if you want to do image featurization or you want to do sentiment analysis, but you're a smaller company or a startup and you don't have access to that mass amounts of data to train those models, we ship them with ML services. So you can easily start either using those directly or doing some transfer learning. So that's something that's an exciting functionality I think it brings particularly.
That's awesome. All right, let's dig a little deeper into what are the capabilities that machine learning services actually has? So we know it has a Jupyter Hub. We know we host like an R studio inside an edge node. And that's important to understand, like ML services in HDInsight actually come with a cluster and then it comes with an edge node, which gets the client tools installed and made available for users to tap into as well. So tell us a little more on what the structure is and what are the components of.
Yeah, so ML services is actually, standard HDInsight clusters are driven by a head node, but with ML services, we utilize the edge node as well to drive our Spark workloads. And with that, it makes it easier for us to continue to ship different developer tools for you. So particular, our studio, when we were first releasing our server, we said, we know users like this, and we want to make it as easy as possible for them. We don't want them to have to do any additional installation. So we ship it right there. Once your HDI cluster is ready to go, you can immediately log into our server and start training your models or experimenting with your data science workloads. And as well, of course, we have, for people who prefer VS Code, Visual Studio, we're integrated with that ecosystem as well.
This is awesome. So with ML services, now you're able to bring in all the goodness of the tools of your choice, all the goodness of the frameworks and platform of your choice, and still leverage the native integration and the work that Microsoft has put in to extend those capabilities even further and integrate it natively within the Azure ecosystem. I think that was a wonderful overview, Katherine. I invite all our users to actually go ahead and try this out. You can go to Azure, sign up for a free trial, spin up a HDInsight cluster, and choose ML services. And with the 9.3 version, you get both R services as well as Python services built natively inside the cluster capabilities itself. Please let us know by tweeting at Azure HDInsight what do you think of this new release. And we'd be happy to take all the feedback that you may have to share with us. Yeah. Thank you, Katherine.
Thanks, Sean.
And thank you, everybody.
Thanks.